Hi everyone, I'm Ain. So this is my first YouTube video. This is quite awkward because I'm not used to talking to the camera, because I thought it would be interesting to actually document the whole process of me planning the whole theme and layout for my room. So my room is, you know, it's been like this for like a year and a half, and I've been sleeping on a thin mattress for so long, but I think it's really time for me to work on my room. Okay, so before you actually jump straight into your mood board, you need to measure your room first. Measure your room and jot it down on a paper and basically reconstruct the measurement of your floor plan on Photoshop, or you can just draw it on a paper or anything. But I would highly suggest drawing it digitally so that you can automatically put the measurements of the furniture that you want to put. It's time to choose a color scheme. I'll be using this water bottle as my reference for my bedroom because I really like the combination of colors over here. The mixture of olive green, the terracotta, the mustard color, and also the yellow ochre and the peach pink. And if people were to ask me how to describe your room in three words, I would say my water bottle. So that is when the mood board comes in handy, because it helps you stay on track on what you need to buy. Okay, so yes, color scheme. Okay, so here comes the best part. So I usually use Pinterest.com. This is like my go-to website. It's like my best friend. I like to use Pinterest to look at images and references that would fit the vibe that I was looking for. So the best thing about Pinterest is that, you know, just search for a keyword and it will automatically give you options. So here I am trying to compile all the images that I think would fit the vibe that I envision, and basically copy and pasting it on Photoshop to visualize the look and feel for the room. So as you can see, I chose this particular picture because I like the look of the green and white look. And then I searched for images that has the color scheme that I aim for to basically tie up the look. So here's a picture of some potteries to go. And like I said, Pinterest is a great place to find images that is inspiring and unique. And the best part about Pinterest is that when you click on a picture, Pinterest will actually suggest you a lot of images that would go and fit with the vision that you want. So next, I will take the color scheme that I've chosen earlier and combine it in this mood board to actually look at the overall vibe. So far, I'm liking the look and I think I'm confident enough with my choices, and I will be committing with the choices that I made. And I'll move forward into making an execution. So for the wall color, I was actually torn between three colors, but I ended up with this olive green because I think it looks the best and fits with my vibe at the moment. And I'm going for the half-painted wall instead of a featured wall to actually make the room look more spacious, because the white is more dominant. So for this side of my room, I decided to keep it simple and minimal with this IKEA cabinet to actually balance out the rattan element in my room. So basically for my bed, I'm going for the all-white bedding and top it off with a lot of pillows and cushions from the color scheme that I've chosen to basically create the whole vibe. Moving on, so for this little corner of my room, I would like to add this rattan chair that I already own. And I'm planning to make like a DIY wall art using fabric to basically complement the wall in this little corner. So there you go, that is how you do your own mood board. So you can apply this to literally anything that involves creativity or planning in general, because it helps you stay on track on what you need to execute for the project. So I hope you enjoyed this content. So like and subscribe if you like what you see, to give me more motivation to actually create more content in the future. So I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye!